Hello everybody who like the big machines, roll like that one. Did you saw that one before? Yes, this has actually a Kubota engine in it, and we have this kind of ECU. Look, Kubota, it says Bosch ECU, which one is EDC17CV45. Yes, CV45, we already connected, so if you need the pinout for this ECU's Bosch, definitely we can guarantee and get you any of these solution. Please register on our web link, so send me information on the WhatsApp and I will definitely guide you so you can all connect and do by yourself online and do programming, chip tuning, whatever you need, wherever you like. So this ECU EDC17 is possible to do a lot of programming. You can do FDPF, EGRA, AdBlue and stuff like that. And remap is not the only way. The chip tuning, the engine check power, for example, like do a diagnostics. In this case, we have already connected because we need to see the fault codes and what the problem can be in there. So we connected the battery, the plugs, all is connected in there. Now I show you the machine, which one is fitted on. I remember you, then this is only Kubota engines. And let's pop in. And so, guys, here you go, the can message, the can, the common rail pressure. Yes, these faults is commonly will come on, all just because there is no sensors plugged in. Yes, but we done on the bench mode, connected with a diagnostic tool, and can see and read all the fault codes of the date. Look, we have the EGR, exhaust gas circulation system, communication error. That's because it's not connected to the EGR valve. Alright, another thing, measurement, the system display, anti-pollution system. What we see in here is actually millibars. This depends how big the differential pressure is and voltage of the differential pressure sensor. This is a dock, which one go for a CAT, DPF, go for a DPF particle filter. And in here you can see announcement particles, how many milligrams into the system. Already, we done this ECU, so that's why you probably not gonna see these values, but that's not a big deal. You can see the temperatures, you can see the voltage, and all other stuff like that. Next thing is the fuel system, actually. As you can see, we see all the fuel system. All is just like that, connected on the bench mode, but the same you can do when you connect to the vehicle right and straight on. Fuel tank, fuel filter, pump, high pressure pump, RPM has how many the engine speeds, and then we go for a next, is again the same. Alright, these are actual values. Look how many they are. There's an engine RPM, target speed, so on, so on, so on. So if you click the pause, you can see the values what you need. I'm trying to find now atmospheric pressure. Where is the particle filter, ash and soot load? Okay, here you go, the EGR values. Yes, 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 these EGR values. Exhaust gas differential pressure. Yes, this value is not the best one if you see that when you're working. Yes, it's about 0.3 bars. That's actually a pretty much big pressure of the system. That means that your DPF filter is going to be full or vehicle will go into the limp mode. Okay, and then we have some more sensors. This is the intake throttle valve air mass. Actually, this is a pretty much good value because this nominates how much air comes into the cylinder by the cylinder timing. And the next thing is, oh wait, here you go. Voila, amount of soot burn during the regeneration of the particle filter is 16,200 milligrams. That means of 16 kilograms. Whoa, that's crappy, too much fuel consumption. So this is another thing, fuel consumption since the regeneration of particle filter. So it's using 33 liters to do a regeneration of a DPF filter. That's kind of lot. And how many engine horse done? It's only 700 horse. It's nothing, it's like brand new. Last particle filter regeneration engine horse. So it's only 10 horse ago was the DPF regeneration. Can you imagine that there, guys? Process state zero, torque speed control zero, oil pressure switch off, and the last map is speed, is there nothing interesting in here? I think so. Oh no, 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 guys, wait. So, particle field regeneration controller three, I don't know, this is probably the level, but don't worry, we can do probably a lot of them and connect with a lot of them. So here we go, a little, plenty of steps. So don't be shy, just contact us on a WhatsApp, definitely we can help you out. So let's go in the parameters. You can do injector coding, display parameters, What is that? Here you go. Injector. What a... It's only got 3 cylinders? Very nice. And you go injector codes. Is it not nice? Injector coding. We don't need that. Sorry, that's we need for expert mode. We don't need that. And another thing, sometimes you can see the particle filter replacement. Here you go. Regeneration. We don't need that. Regeneration counter restart. It's called little name curva, but you don't hear that. A differential pressure reset and pressure valve release reset. So these are things which one you always need to do a correctly stuff. So we're gonna do that, and then we see how much we will get measurement in here. This thing is actually what it does. Here you go. Is used to reset the counter particle filter regulation number, and that way a new working cycle of the filter starts. Nice, I love that thing. So I think so. We're gonna click that button, and let's see what we have. 0 RPM, that's cool. Ignition on, that's cool. Click on accept to perform the maintenance, and probably we'll get the error code. No, the process has finished. Quick as that. Then the next thing is differential pressure reset. So we click accept, yes we accept, go baba, and we see plenty of stuff in C, if the filter is clogged and so on, RPM, click OK. And look, 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 fuel consumption, 16 kilograms, click on accept, perform the suit load reset. This is a very, very, very important stuff to do a correct chip tuning, I would say. Oh, do you love that measurement? It's 0-0. Whoa, I love that stuff. Do you? Okay, we have that done, that done. And this is the thing if you need. Yeah, I just show you, but I will not gonna do it. Because how I can do it if the ECU is on the table. But this is the stuff, how you do the regeneration. You have all these buttons. You connect, you start, you activate. If you need, just in case, I will zoom like that. So you click the pause and read instruction how you do a regeneration by yourself on your own way. So stay tuned, contact us on the WhatsApp if you need your vehicles to be done. Oh, sorry, I don't want to do that. Just stay tuned, contact us, and see you on the next video. So we're gonna install the ECU now, test it out. I hope so, I will add some more video how this thing will go on the full power and full potential. Stay tuned, follow for more. See you next time.